Weeks ago, I misplaced my remote. The TV's this far away from the bed. I could have changed it manually. But no, it's like, no, where's the remote? I can't watch TV without the remote. I had to phone a remote hotline. I can't find my remote. Help me. Okay, stay on the phone. We'll talk you down, man. I've been there. Okay. Take some deep breaths. We're going to send somebody with a loaner. Just stay on the phone. Hurry, I'm missing Cosby. Hurry. I said that, you know what I do with my remote? I do what I call video laps. I go from 0 to 30, 0 to 30, all the way. I have to know what's on every channel. Boy. Sometimes even check the high numbers, like 78. You never know. Well, how do you know if you don't check that number? Huh? Why is that number there in the first place? You ever been to a friend's house and they don't even have a TV? It's like, whoa. How long do we have to stay here?
I thought we'd just sit around and talk.
About what? All right, I gotta have a TV wherever I go. Where I live in Toronto, Canada, I have every cable choice possible. I have a movie channel, of course. But it's kind of embarrassing having the movie channel in Canada because we have these Canadian content rulings that means one out of every four movies has to be Canadian. I don't know if you've ever seen a Canadian movie, but they're pretty easy to spot. They all look like this. So anyways, hey. They all look like that. Yeah, it's so embarrassing, bro. It's a microphone in every shot. I can't believe. Don't they look through the lens when they shoot this stuff? I mean, come on. It doesn't take a genius to see the equipment dangling there. I mean, rent a truck in the background, the girl with the donuts. Who wants a donut? Get out of the shot already. We're trying to shoot a movie here. Should be a credit at the end of the movie, Mr. Microphone, bye. You know, it's amazing. It's embarrassing. What else do I got? Cable choices. I got a video channel. I watch some music videos, but my only complaint about music videos is when the video has nothing to do with the song. That kills me, you know? Guy's singing about going to the drive-in with his best girl, and here's some blender with wings going by. What the hell does this mean? I don't know. I mean, what kind of nightmare are we watching here? What is this? Had this one Sledgehammer by Peter Gabriel. Guy standing there going... There's a train going around his head, cotton candy hair, carrots coming out of his eyeballs. What the hell does this mean? Hey, love to party with him, Mr. Gabriel, but leave the door open just a crack, will you? Jeez. What is this? You know, I think the funniest thing I've seen on TV a little while ago, about 2 weeks ago, I was doing a video lap about 2 in the morning. All of a sudden, I hit a channel, and there's like Oral Roberts. And this guy says that if he doesn't get $4.5 million by the end of March, God's gonna take him away. And I'm thinking, how can I tie up the phones? Hello, hat. Thank you very much. You're great. Thank you.
Vanna, we've challenged Alex Trebek to play Wheel of Fortune.
Do I get a clue?
Of course. It's a phrase, and it could change your life.
Gotcha. I bet you it's spin to win, because that's what the people do on Wheel of Fortune.
I've got one for you. Okay, what's my clue?
It's the ultimate big money risk.
Well, that's not too hard. It's win it all or lose it all. That's what you do on Jeopardy.
America's two most watched game shows, Jeopardy and Wheel of Fortune.
They're really a lot harder than this.
I thought it was hard.
Nah, we're just smart.
The winning combination here on TV 20.
The Green Toyota Green on Dirksen Late Show takes you where the action is.
Mm-hmm.
Hollywood's tough guys strut their stuff Friday nights at 11:30 on the Green Toyota Green on Dirksen Late Show.
This week, Robert Wagner stars in Death at Love House, Friday night at 11:30 on TV.
Kids of all ages will enjoy the Toy Train Show this Sunday at the Knights of Columbus Hall in Springfield. Take the whole family to the Arts and Crafts Show and sale this Sunday, March 29th at the Prairie Capital Convention Center from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. There's a chili soup and sandwich supper, along with a simulated old-time radio variety show this Sunday at the First United Methodist Church in Springfield.
Okay, welcome back. That was great, Mike. That's good. That's good. I noticed, Johnny, you know, your English is good enough. You were catching everything. You were laughing at everything.
I wish I could have done it myself.
Yeah, that comedy's good. Yeah. Let me ask you a question. What jokes do they tell in Poland? I mean, do they have, like, Albanian jokes? You know?
No.
No, that
Russian,
kind of
yeah?
So, and you, London man, and activity in America, in Toronto. And how's Toronto going to do? How's the baseball season looking at you? You're a sports fan.
Yeah, I like baseball. Blue Jays, I hope they do better this year. I know it's going to be hard to compete with last year's World Series. That was pretty exciting.
That was a great.
I think baseball is the one sport that I really don't begrudge the players getting their money, because when you think about it, you know, baseball is like, you think you have pressure in your lives. I mean, you think back to the World Series, Game 6, bottom of the ninth, two strikes, two outs, Mookie Wilson at the plate. Now there's some pressure, right? Can you imagine what was going on in Mookie's head? Oh God, please give me a hit, please. Because he knows one strike and the Mets are history, and the fans are going, Mookie, Mookie, sharpening objects, Mookie, we know where you live, Mookie. His address is on the scoreboard, Mookie. And he pulled through, man. He got that hit, and he's so happy he's on the bag going, yeah, I got a hit. It's not me that lost the game. Who's up now? Who's up now? Hate being that next guy, boy. Imagine the next guy. Oh, God, I thought they're going to kill Mookie. Oh, God. He wouldn't even have remembered my name. I guess the guy really had to feel sorry for was Buckner. I mean,
that's terrible.
If I was Buckner, I wouldn't even gone back to Boston. I would have gone on the phone, honey, get the kids in the car, get the hell out of there. I'll meet you in Florida. Just get the hell out of there. She's packing up the car. The fans are on the lawn, taking a trip, Mrs. Buckner. Going somewhere, are we?
Well, the fans in Canada are a little, they're tame compared to down here, right?
Very tame, but
very
you know,
nice up there.
It's, you know, they sit there and they go, oh, that's nice.
Yeah. He got a hit, that's good.
You know, I think I hope I'm alive to see the weirdest thing that could possibly happen in baseball, and that would be the Blue Jays and the Expos in the World Series. That's when you Americans would go, well, I never really liked baseball. Sure. Let's see what else is on here. And it'd be so weird having baseball up in Canada, you know, and during the winter and the snow. And they're bringing in the relief pitcher now. Mush.
Well, we're looking forward. And keep going with this career. It's going great for you. And April 12th, right? That's when the show's on. April 12th. We'll watch that. Thanks, both of you. It was a lot of fun with you tonight. And thanks a lot, everyone. Good night.
Some of the guests of Nightlife stay at the UN Plaza. Enjoy what New York has to offer, then experience the hotel that rises above the rest, the United Nations Plaza Hotel. For reservations, call 1-800-228-9000. Transportation provided by Esquire Limousine, New York's most prestigious limousine service, where the service performed is truly personal. When in New York, call 212-737-7000 for Esquire Limousine Service. If you're going to be in New York and would like to be in our studio audience, send a self-addressed stamped envelope to Tickets, care of Nightlife, Post Office Box 1600, Gracie Station, New York, New York, 10028. I'm Dan.